Hello friend, welcome back to my lecture on event handling. And in previous lecture I have discussed about the key event and key listener. So in continuation of the previous lectures, I am discussing here about the mouse event and mouse motion event. So basically for this mouse event and mouse motion event, we require mouse listener, and there are number of functions of this mouse listener. We have been mouse clicked, mouse entered, mouse exited, mouse pressed, mouse released. So in when we click on the mouse, then mouse clicked event will generate, invoked when the mouse has been clicked on a component, and mouse entered event will invoke when mouse enters on the component. So this is mouse entered event, and their argument is mouse event. Same argument is here also. Mouse exited, invoked when mouse exit a component, and mouse pressed event invokes when a mouse button has been pressed on component, and mouse released invoked when a mouse button has been released on a component. So this is opposite of mouse pressed. Mouse released is opposite of mouse pressed, and mouse exited is opposite of mouse entered. Mouse clicked means when we are clicking on a component. So these are the different event of the mouse listener, and we can write these event like that, this function like that. In public void mouse click, mouse event E. So mouse event is a class accordingly. So it E is the object, and the same way we have public void mouse enter, mouse event E. Public void mouse exited, mouse event E. So these are the function, and mouse press, mouse event E, and public void mouse release, mouse event E. So the function we have, we will use these functions for, in case of the mouse event. And another class is mouse motion listener, where we have mouse dragged, mouse moved function, and other function also. So the mouse move, mouse dragged is invoked when a mouse button is pressed over a component and dragged, called several times as a mouse is dragged. So whenever we press the mouse button and then drag it, means suppose we have pressed mouse button on any component, on any icon, and then we are dragging it. So mouse dragged event will generate, and mouse moved simply as we are moving the mouse in this screen. So in this case, mouse moved event will generate, invoked when a mouse cursor has been moved onto component, but on buttons has been pushed, but no button has been pushed. So simply we are moving the mouse on screen, it is mouse moved. And after pressing, suppose we are moving mouse after pressing the button on a particular component, then it is called mouse dragged. So this is the difference between mouse moved and mouse dragged. Now see the program. In this program we are I'm showing mouse event. So again, the pattern of the program is same as the pattern of the key listener and action listener program. So we have import java.awt.star, and then another one is import java.awt.event.star, import java.applet.star. So public class mouse event, extend applet, implement mouse listener, and mouse motion listener. So we are doing here mouse event as well as mouse motion event. So public class mouse event, extend applet. So public class mouse event, extend applet. So this is applet program, and we are doing mouse event as well as mouse motion event. So that's why we have written here implement mouse listener and mouse motion listener. So you can see here the string message, this is initially blank, and x and y coordinate, mx equals to 0, my equals to 0. So we have been two coordinate, x and y. So we have written here mx, my means mouse x, mouse y coordinate. So after this statement we have init function. So we are writing here add mouse listener and add mouse motion listener. So add mouse listener this and add mouse motion listener this. We have written these two statements here, means the same class is added here. Same class is mouse listener as well as mouse motion listener. So we are adding the same class in this mouse event class. So the effect of all the event, mouse event as well as mouse motion event, will apply on this program, and that's why we have added here this keyword. So this is a object of the same class, and the same class is the mouse instance class as well as mouse motion listener class. Now we can apply the all the function of the mouse listener and mouse motion listener. So this is the mouse clicked mouse event ME. So wherever we will click the mouse at position 0, 10, it will display mouse clicked, and repaint will be executed here. So this is repaint. Repaint will execute the paint function. You can see here in the next slide, you can see here the paint function, and in paint function we have written here g.drawstring message mx comma my. So the message which we have stored in the previous slide, that will be displayed on x and y coordinate. You can see here message mouse clicked. So we have recorded the message mouse clicked string on msg variable, and this will be displayed on the x and y coordinate, and it will execute repaint function. So you can see here the paint function, paint graphics g dot draw string same message, and message will be displayed x and y coordinate, mx and my we have written here. So now the another function, public void mouse entered mouse event me. So here the message is mouse entered, and again we are writing here repaint function, and x and y already we have given the value. So in this case x and y is 0, 10, and initially we have 0, 0. So mouse entered will be the message mouse entered will be displayed on the 0, 0 position, because these are the local variable, locally initialized these variable, and their existence will end after this curly bracket, means their value will be removed after this curly bracket. So x and y as a globally initialized by this statement. So x and y is 0. So there we are writing here mouse entered, and mouse entered will be displayed at 0, 0 position. And now we have another function, mouse exited function. Again we have written here inside the bracket mouse event me, and mouse exited will be stored on message, and this will be printed on through repaint function, and it will be printed at the 0, 0 position. Now we have mouse press. So we can see this is after running this complete program, we can see all the function, and all the function are properly implemented or not. So we will have the output of all this. So mouse pressed, this is mouse pressed. Already we have written here mouse clicked, mouse entered, mouse exited. So as we enter mouse on the window area, frame area, then it will display mouse entered message at 0, 0 position. As we come out from the window area, then it will display mouse exited message at 0, 0 position. And in this case we have written here mouse clicked. So as we are clicking mouse on frame area, then it will display at 0, 10 position this particular message, mouse clicked message. And here we have written here mouse pressed and released. This is the setup function. So this is opposite, mouse released is opposite of mouse pressed. So mouse pressed function, in this function we have written here this statement me dot get x and me dot get y. So the position where we are pressing the mouse, it will record that position, it will retrieve that position. Get x means retrieve the x position, x and y coordinate of that position. ME means mouse event will occur at that position, and ME dot get x, ME dot get y means x and y both coordinate will be retrieved by this statement. And now we have the new value at mx and my. Initially mx is 0, my is also 0. Now mx and my having the value of the pressing location where we have pressed the mouse. Suppose we have pressed in this location, so it will display the x and y coordinate of this location. It will record x and y coordinate of that position by get x and get y function. So we have me.getx, me.getY, and the message is mouse pressed, and then we will run the repaint. So mx and my position will display the message mouse pressed, and in this case mx and my will be the value of get x and get y. And mouse release, again in case of the mouse release, we will retrieve the same value get x and get y, and we'll store these values in mx and my, and message will be printed by the paint function. The message will be mouse release message, and this message will be printed in the same location. And this is mouse drag. In case of the mouse drag, suppose we have pressed a component, pressed upon a component, and then we are dragging the mouse from that component, then again we will have this me.getx and me.gety. So it will display the location mouse dragged at so it status, means it will display the message on status bar mouse dragged at. At means from which position we are dragging the mouse. So it will retrieve the initial location. So getx will display the message, it will retrieve the value of the coordinate of x coordinate of the position where we have started dragging, and get y is the y coordinate of location where we are dragging the component. So we have mx and my both value, and mx and my we are showing on the status bar mouse dragged at mx. Mx is the variable plus again we are writing here comma and then y. So we are writing here the position on status bar where we have dragged the item, and then we are running the repaint function, and the same message will be displayed on the x and y coordinate which we have retrieved the dragging position. So at that position it will display the message will be initially the value of message is blank, so we can write some value also here. So we have not mentioned any value, so we can write here value also. And this is mouse moved. Again, in case of the mouse moved, we are running getx and gety function. So it will display the mouse moved at, means from which position we are moving the mouse. Suppose initially mouse is at this position, and suppose we are moving from this position to another position. So the initial position will be recorded, retrieved by getx and gety function, and mx and my having the initial position. So on status bar will display mouse moved at this mx comma my. So this is variable plus comma is a string plus variable, and this is again variable. So we will write this way, and this is the program. And here we have written here repaint, means it will execute the paint function. So these are the function, these are the different function related to key event, and this program showing mouse event and mouse motion both event. So we have written here implement mouse listener and mouse motion listener. So we have written here mouse clicked, mouse entered, mouse exited, and mouse pressed, mouse release, all are the mouse listener function, and mouse dragged, mouse moved, they are mouse motion listeners part, mouse motion listener interface part of mouse motion listener interface. So these are the different functions, mouse listener and mouse motion listener functions. So this is another program, and in this program we have not mentioned the complete program, we have mentioned only the syntax. So class mouse handler for the draw canvas, and extend mouse adapter, implement mouse listener. So we can use mouse adapter as well as mouse listener, and here we have mouse motion listener also. So you can see here, because two classes cannot be extended, so one class and another interface we can use, and we can use more than one interface, but more than one class cannot be extended. So multiple is not possible, multiple inheritance is not possible in Java. So here we have saved mouse x and saved mouse y. So we have x and y coordinate So we have integer x and y coordinate, and function are mouse press, mouse drag, mouse move, mouse enter, mouse exited, mouse click, mouse release. So these different mouse functions, and we can use more than these functions. We have lots of functions of the mouse movement, and but the commonly used functions are these functions. These are the mouse event function, and this way we can do the programming of the mouse, mouse related programming. So you can see another slide where we have different functions. So public void, mouse press, mouse released, mouse entered, mouse exited, mouse click, so and so on. And we can use here public class, my class, implement mouse listener, mouse motion listener, and we have to add these listener on our screen, otherwise it will not work. So we must have to add the listener also. So as in case of the action listener, we have to add action listener on the button, because action listener is applied on the button. And in case of the key listener, we add key listener with our text box, because text box read the key listener. And same way in our program, we have added add mouse listener and add mouse motion listener. This is the object of the same class. So thank you very much, guys.